Lady Goggins.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your co-hosts for the evening, Alexis Costello, Juan Soto, and Mia McKenzie.
God, we thank you for this time we can come together, God, in fellowship, and God, just lift each other up, God, because we worked hard this season, all of our seasons, God. We worked hard and all that for the glory of your kingdom, God, not for our kingdoms, God, but we just pray, God, that if there's anything that we might have done this season, God, no matter if we were the star player or just playing our role on the court, God, or on the field, I pray that you were lifted up, God, and you might draw people to you, God. We thank you for everything that you've done for us, God. Everything's possible because of your Son. Amen. All right, welcome again. My name is Juan, and I'm one of your hosts tonight. Where's my track team at? Yeah!
Hey, what's up? My name is Alexis. I'm another host for tonight. I see my softball girls back there.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mia, and I play on the volleyball team. Well, everybody looks so beautiful.
Juan, I really gotta say, I'm really digging that bow tie.
I appreciate it. I got it from my boy, Kurt McConnell. Kurt McConnell, please stand up. Shout out to Ethan Harper.
Yes.
Tyler Bird.
But you know what? We got some national champions in the house. Yeah.
Where are they at?
Now, I need the basketball team. Please rise. Be recognized. We have a member on the track team.
Dakira Ramsey.
A member on the women's wrestling team.
Cody.
Please rise
and
be recognized one more time.
There they are.
Yeah.
Awesome job, y'all. We also want to give a quick little shout out to the team who went to all the way to Las Vegas. Bowling team, where are you at?
Woo!
Vegas.
What happened to Vegas stays in Vegas, right?
They're over there.
Man, I love bowling. It's just right up.
Supportive team on campus.
Yeah.
Hey, but seriously, guys, can you stop taking all the boiled eggs at breakfast?
Another accomplishment we'd like to recognize is the women's basketball team for finishing third at nationals. Can you please stand up, be recognized? Where are you at? Women's basketball.
Congrats.
And shout out to my girls. We finished third too.
You know, man, y'all did do pretty good this season. Y'all almost won, you know, kind of like Midnight Madness.
Yeah. All right. So we got women's soccer in the house. Congrats for winning regionals. And men's soccer. You know, guys, there's always next year.
Where is the clay target team, shooting team? I'd like to finally to beat you guys. Can you stand up one more time, please? There you are. Thank you, thank you. Nice meeting you guys.
Thanks for Target. And also, how about the archer team for shutting down the roads for a tournament? Where's the archer team at? Happy birthday to Brooke Martin too.
Really cool teams. Have y'all seen the women's lacrosse website pictures? Can we just take a look at those?
Yeah.
I mean, that's true beauty right there. I mean, even the NCAA couldn't resist putting it up on their Twitter account.
Alright, hey, cheerleaders, if you're out there, let's just stick to the basics. We all know why. Let's see.
The track team and the cross country team have had their own struggles this season too. I mean, poor freshmen have went through three different coaches this year.
Three coaches?
Yeah, I mean, track is just running everyone off.
And we can't forget about the baseball team. They put up a really big fight this year. Literally.
Literally.
A big fight.
A big fight.
A big fight. Maybe if you put that much effort into the game, you would have won.
Unfortunately, guys, you just took your first loss in the category for most couples on the team. This year, the award goes to...
Drum roll, please.
The tennis team!
Alright, you all know I play volleyball, right? And in this sport, we usually use our hands, but the men's team found another way to play it. And they even made it on TV. On ESPN's not top 10 plays of the year.
Number three, Alejandro Robles takes a spike.
Yes.
In face. And then he just, yeah, well, guys, I'm good. Reflexes slow.
Matt, you were pretty bad.
Let's give it up one more time for all the sports. Alright, and now we're going to transition to the main event tonight. We're going to go right to the awards right now.
To present our first award of the night for record-breaking male and female performance of the year, we would like to welcome one of our history professors and our vice president for academic affairs, the lovely couple, Mrs. Hensel and Dr. Hensel.
Whether it's breaking a personal goal or setting a new school record, they all dream of achieving greatness. However, only a few achieve something that hasn't been done before.
Tonight, we recognize the male athletes that were able to have that unforgettable performance in a game or throughout the season. Here are the nominees for the record-breaking male performance.
Your nominees for record-breaking male performance: Daniel Gooden in baseball, and Steve Griffin. In Spartan College, he put up 3 home runs, 2 grand slams, 10 RBIs, 3 runs scored, and 12 total bases. Caleb Sheely of Clay Target. Sheely is a senior from Worcester Woodward. After participating in Clay Target shooting for only 3.5 months, Caleb took first place in Trap Division in Maryland by breaking 96 out of 100 targets. Alex Sobers of Minnesota. FINA World Swimming Championships, as well as the Commonwealth Games, where he set the Barbados national record in the 200 freestyle. Sobers has an undefeated dual meet record of 26 wins and 0 losses. He's a 6-time SCAA SC Conference Champion and 9-time ECAC Conference Champion. Sober sold 7 EC school records and has earned NCAA National Championship qualifying times at 9 different events this season.
And the winner for record-breaking male performance of the year is Daniel Goodman.
From the time they are young girls, most female athletes aim to break all stereotypes and work extra hard so they can be the best at what they do. Whether it's hitting every target or going undefeated in a tournament, they put in countless hours of effort and work in hopes of having little to no errors.
The following athletes were able to give us extraordinary showings this year. Here are the nominees for record-breaking female performance.
Your nominees for record-breaking female performance. Julie McGraw, women's volleyball. Julie is a junior from Copenhagen, Denmark. She was the NCCAA South Region Player of the Year and National Player of the Year. She was also voted Team Staff ABCA National Player of the Year, was the NCCAA First Team All-American, and led the team in points with an average of 4.6 per set. She was first in conference in blocks per set and total number of blocks. Abby Nett of Women's Wrestling. Abby's a sophomore from St. Louis, Louisiana. She finished third at the WCWA National Tournament and had a season record of 41 wins and 8 losses. She became the U23 World Team member by winning the trials and qualified for the USA Senior World Team Trials. Shelby Evans of Clay Target. Shelby is a senior from Crawford, Georgia. She took 5 overall female at the SCTP National Collegiate Championship in Ohio. These are your nominees for record-breaking female performance.
And the winner for record-breaking female performance of the year, Julie DeBlanc.
Should be proud of yourselves for the effort that you put into the classroom and that you put onto the field or the court or wherever you compete. And this year we did have a few select teams have that one special game for that one season that went down in the history books, which separates them from the crowd.
Whether it's setting a new conference record or winning a national title, they go out and set themselves apart from everyone else. The following teams gave us some of the best performances EC has ever seen. Here are a few nominees for the record-breaking team performance.
Your nominees for record-breaking team performance. clay target shooting. The clay target team broke 2,710 out of the 3,000 targets to win the SCTP National Collegiate Championship title in Ohio. Men's swimmer. The men had a perfect 11-mile undefeated dual meet season. They were the ECAC conference champions and the SCSC conference champions. Women's volleyball. The Lady Lions had their first ever 20-win season. They finished first in the South Division of Conference Carolinas, as well as second overall in the conference. They have two first-team NCCAA All-Americans, as well as one Player of the Year. The only team in the conference to upset the undefeated Barton College, they were ranked eighth nationally and placed third at the NCCAA Nationals. These are your nominees for record-breaking team performance.
And the winner for record-breaking team performance of the year is Clay Target Shooting!
To invite the head of our kinesiology department, Dr. Rizel.
Here at Emmanuel College, we stress the student and the phrase student-athlete. This year you all did an outstanding job showing your talents both in and outside the classroom. We want to take a moment to recognize our athletes that excelled and were selected to the Conference Carolinas Presidential Honor Roll List. Emmanuel College had the second most athletes between Conference Carolina schools who made the Presidential Honor Roll List. We had a total of 334 athletes who achieved a 3.2 or higher GPA this past fall. If you achieve a 3.2 or higher, will you please stand to be recognized? Representative for Emmanuel College, on behalf of the faculty, I want to thank you for all your hard work in the classroom and continue to make Emmanuel College proud. Thank you.
We would like to invite our Assistant Athletic Director of Academic Success, Mr. Kirk McConnell, to come up and recognize the Chi Alpha Sigma sorority.
Well, good evening. I would like to add to what Dr. Rizelt has said about our academic achievements and our student athletes. Chi Alpha Sigma is the National Honor Society for Collegiate Student Athletics. Student athletes who have maintained a cumulative grade point average of 3.6 or higher through at least seven semesters of college work and who have one varsity letter of competition are eligible for induction. This year, we have 28 graduating seniors being inducted into Emmanuel's inaugural class of Chi Alpha Sigma. So if you're graduating with a 3.6 or higher and have a varsity letter, would you please stand at this time? And if you would please meet me immediately after the ceremony tonight, right down front, we have a certificate that we'd like to give to each of you. So thank you and congratulations on your hard work.
Part of our mission at Emmanuel College is to serve others. All of our teams do a great job being involved in the community and serving those in need. Thank you. Community service is important not only for those we serve, but for our own spiritual, personal, and overall growth. Community service is defined as volunteer work intended to help others. The following team did an amazing job in exemplifying that. Here are some of the examples of the community service they did to earn this award.
The team with the most community service hours for the year is women's soccer. The ladies volunteer time and money throughout the year in many different service projects, including bringing baskets to the national tournament, supplies for the Royston Animal Hospital. They taught soccer at Royston, Carnesville, and Livonia Elementary. The girls coached 3 hours a week for 16 weeks at Rapids Franklin County Soccer Club. All in all, they totaled around 80 community service hours this year.
Are you here?
Our next award for Best Female Male Newcomer of the Year will be presented by our Vice President of Development and one of our professors in the Business Department, Mr. and Mrs. James.
Good evening. Coaches spend countless hours, days, and months recruiting in hopes of bringing that one special athlete who can immediately make an impact on their program. Whether it is a true freshman or a transfer, they hope and they pray that they have made the right choice when bringing in new recruits.
The following athletes not only met the expectations of their coach, but they did far more than that to exceed their highest expectations. Here are the nominees for the Best Female Newcomer of the Year.
Your nominees for Female Newcomer of the Year: Lindsay Lee of Women's Soccer. Lee is a sophomore from Lawrenceville, Georgia. She was the leading scorer with 11 goals, including 5 game-winning goals. Lee led the team to its first ever winning season in EC history. She was on the regional all-tournament team and the all-region team. Alex Quarles of Women's Track and Field. She was the second scorer on the team, and she increased her PR from 21 minutes 12 seconds in high school to 19 minutes 13 seconds in her first collegiate 5K. Asia Avery from Women's Volleyball. Asia is a sophomore from Lawrenceville, Georgia. She was a first team NCCAA All-American and was on the first team NCCAA South Region team. She was the best defensive player in the Conference Carolinas as she led the conference in digs per set. These are your nominees for Female Newcomer of the Year.
And the winner of the
the best female newcomer of the year is Lindsay Lee. Here are the nomination for the best male newcomer of the year.
Your nominees for male newcomer of the year: Will Boomer of Men's Cross Country. Will is a freshman from Vance County, Georgia. He improved his PR from 1807 high school to 1649 for his first collegiate 5K. Will went from the fifth man score to the second man score. He has a PR of 26:40 with 8,000 meters. Colton Evans of Clay Tart. Colton is a freshman from Crawford, Georgia. He led the team to a fifth place finish in the ACUY National Collegiate Championship in San Antonio, Texas. He has an individual dual meet record of 20 wins and 1 loss. He's a 6-time SCSC conference champion and a 9-time ECAC conference champion. He was MVP of the SCSC conference championships, holds 5 school records, and has earned NCAA national championship qualifying times in 9 different events this season. These are your nominees for Male Newcomer of the Year.
And it's my pleasure to present the winner of the Best Male Newcomer of the Year, Tiago Russell.
Present our award for biggest upset of the year, our head athletic trainer, Miss Campbell.
Biggest upset of the year.
Men's swimming. The men's swim team won the first and last event at the 2018 ECAC Swimming and Diving Championships over the U.S. Naval Academy and 26 other NCAA D1 schools. The relay team consisted of Alexandra Wicks, Mendez, Rosa, and Sobers. The men's team took third overall out of 33 teams behind Navy and Columbia University. Women's volleyball. The Lady Lions swept Barton College in 3 sets. Barton was undefeated in the conference, and the Lady Lions gave them their only loss of the season. Barton went on to win the conference championship. Women's wrestling, Aisha Washington. Aisha is a sophomore from Vista, California. She upset 4 top-ranked WCWA wrestlers, including the number 3 and number 5 ranked wrestlers at the Tournament of Champions and the number 1 and 2 ranked wrestlers at the NWCA National Duel. These are your nominees for Biggest Upset of the Year.
And the winner for the Biggest Upset of the Year is Women's Volleyball.
The Faculty Athletic Club was established in hopes of building a better connection between the faculty and our student athletes. Members of the club got to travel, watch practices, attend games, some hosted teams in their home homes, and got an inside look at what we as athletes go through on a weekly basis. Through these great connections we made, we believe that we made gains in building that relationship between our faculty and our athletics. We want to take a moment to not only recognize but thank the members of the FAC for their time and willingness to be a part of the program.
Your support means more than we can describe. Can Paige Boomer, Blake Rackley, Nancy Cobb, Danny Bird, Jonathan Howell, and Deborah Miller please stand and be recognized? Now, we all know the student athletes are talented in the classroom, the court, and the field, but we also have some other hidden talents. This year, the track team was finally able to steal the Midnight Madness Talent Show trophy from women's volleyball. Let's give it up for the track team and their great dance moves. As you all know, one of the awards we give out at Leo Awards is Best Entertainment Video of the Year. This year, we had three teams showcase their creativity.
So next up, we're going to show you the three videos. And after all the videos are done playing, you will all be able to vote on who the winner is. So here's the first video.
Man. I wish I could do this all the time. Like, even with the girls, just make them do what I want to. That'd be great.
Dancing today. square.
All right, to cast your vote, please take out your phones and go to Kahoot.it. Yeah. All right, type in the code and vote for the team that you think should be your winner this year.
I vote.
If you can find something.
Of the year, let's come welcome back to the stage our Assistant Athletic Director of Academic Success, Mr. Kirk McConnell. Woo!
Associate Athletic Director for Compliance, Ms. Bridget Allen. From conference records to national bids, we were fortunate this year to have multiple women's teams accomplish some great things. The following teams work hard and have earned the right to be considered some of the top teams at Emanuel. Here are the nominees for the best women's team of the year.
Your nominees for women's team of the year. Women's swimming. The ladies have perfect 12-0 undefeated dual meet season. The first undefeated season in EC women's swimming history. They were the SCSC conference champions. Won 12 out of 18 events, set 5 school records, 12 conference records, and produced 27 conference champions. They also had the highest NCAA D2 team GPA in the country in the fall of 2017. Women's volleyball. The ladies had the most successful season in EC volleyball history. This was their first 20-win season. They finished first in Conference Carolina South Division and second overall in the conference. They produced 2 first-team NCCAA All-Americans and placed top 3 in 13 out of the 16 statistical categories in the conference. They ranked number 8 nationally and placed 3rd in nationals. Women's wrestling. They were 3rd at the NWCA National Dual Tournament and 4th at the WCWA National Tournament. They had 1 national champion and 5 All-Americans.
You guys give it up for these 3 ladies' teams again. And the winner of the 2018 Best Women's Team of the Year. Women's Swimming.
Here are our nominees for Men's Team of the Year.
Your nominees for Men's Team of the Year.
Men's Basketball. The men's basketball team is NCCAA National Champions. This was their 11th season in a row, winning 20-plus games. They finished with 23 wins, an NCCAA Coach of the Year, 1 First Team All-American, and a Tournament Most Outstanding Player. Men's Clay Target. The Clay Target team defeated the University of Alabama to win their first national championship. They dominated the competition all season long by finishing first place at 3 events in a row. Men's Swimming. The men's swim team had perfect 11-0 undefeated dual meet season. They were the ECAC Conference Champions and the SCSC Conference Champions. They were also an NCAA Division II Academic All-American team.
Give it up for those nominees again. And the winner for the best men's team of the year goes to men's basketball.
Thank
The next award for Best Female Male Athlete of the Year will be presented by our Assistant Athletic Director and Head Volleyball Coach, Mrs. Ashford, and Assistant Athletic Director of Sports Communications and Marketing, Mr. Lance Miller.
I need us a little taller over here. Good evening, everyone. How are y'all doing? Man, that didn't sound very exciting, sorry. Can y'all do better?
Oh, yeah!
A little better. All right. Every year, there are select few athletes that go the extra mile and achieve greatness. They commit themselves to getting better, and in the end, they go above and beyond expectations.
The following athletes fully committed themselves this past year and were able to give us some of the best performances in the history of Emmanuel Athletics. Here are the nominees for Female Athlete of the Year.
Your nominees for Female Athlete of the Year: Julie DeBluff, women's volleyball. Julie's a junior from Copenhagen, Denmark. She was the NCCAA South Region Player of the Year and the NCCAA National Player of the Year. Also the Team Snap ABCA National Player of the Year. She was an NCCAA First Team All-American, among the best in the conference in several categories, team captain, and carries a 3.8 GPA. Cody Fowl, women's wrestler. Cody's a sophomore from Brush, Colorado. She had a perfect 37-0 undefeated season. She was the WCWA National Champion, ranked second on the USA senior level for women's wrestling, and is a two-time U23 World Team member. Michaela Trombley of women's basketball. Trombley is a senior from Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. She was a two-time NCCAA All-American, Player of the Year in the NCCAA South Region, NCCAA First Team All-American. She scored over 1,000 career points and led the team to winning the NCCAA South Region tournament.
And the winner for the Female Athlete of the Year is Cody Fowl. Congratulations again, Cody, and here are your nominees for Male Athlete of the Year.
Colton Evans, Clay Talking. Colton is a freshman from Crawford, Georgia. He led the team to a fifth place finish in the ACUI National Collegiate Championship in San Antonio, Texas. Daniel Gooden of baseball. Daniel is a senior from Griffin, Georgia. Against Barton, he put up 3 home runs, 2 grand slams, 10 RBIs, 3 runs scored, 1 walk, and 12 total bases. Alex Sobers of men's swimming. Sobers is a sophomore from Bridgetown, Barbados. He competed in the 2017 FINA World Swimming Championships, as well as the Commonwealth Games, where he set the Barbados national record in 200 freestyle. Sobers has an undefeated dual meet record of 26 wins and 0 losses. He's a 6-time SCSC Conference Champion and a 9-time ECAC Conference Champion. He holds 7 EC school records and earned NCAA National Championship qualifying times in 9 different events this season.
And the winner for Male Athlete of the Year is Alex Sobers.
Coach
First, let me say how proud I am of all of our athletes and all the teams and how you've competed this year. These are astounding statistics, and we're very proud of all of these accomplishments this year. Here at Emmanuel, we are blessed to have an amazing group of coaches who pour into the lives of our students daily. The ability to coach, mentor, and lead young men and women while balancing everyday struggles of their own lives is not an easy task. This year was an exceptional year. We had multiple coaches who achieved great success. Please, let's give a round of applause to all of our coaches. The following coaches were able to lead their teams to some of the highest levels we've ever been able to achieve at Emmanuel. Here are the nominees for Coach of the Year.
Your nominees for Coach of the Year: Inga Ashford of Women's Volleyball. Inga led her team to the best season in school history. They finished third place at NCCAA National Tournament. She had one NCCAA National Player of the Year and two First Team All-Americans. The ladies finished second in the conference. Link Davis of Women's Wrestling. Coach Davis finished third at the National Duels and had a third place finish at the WCWA National Tournament. He had six All-Americans, one national champion, and coached two World Team Member qualifiers. Nathan Harrell of Women's Soccer. Coach Harrell led his team to the best season in BC Women's Soccer history. They defeated Southern Wesleyan University at the NCCAA South Region Tournament to become the South Region Champions.
Okay, we had a little malfunction there. And the 2018 Coach of the Year is Inga Ashford.
For Employee of the Year and the Bill White Award will be presented by our awesome athletic director, Mr. Mormon.
The Employee of the Year is an award given to an athletic department staff member who embodies the values of our department, projects a positive attitude on his or her co-workers, faces adversity head-on with integrity, and motivates those around him or her. These contagious characteristics best represent what an Emmanuel College athletic staff member should be. To help present this award with me and to share some personal words about this year's winner, I'd like to ask Ms. Sandy Campbell to come to the stage.
Matt, you have the heart of a lion. You are the warrior among warriors. In the book of James 1, chapter 1, verse 2, in James' teaching, I like to read this. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of any kind, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. A little background about Matt. Matt came to me 2 years ago as an intern graduate assistant. He was also taking 8 hours in the chemistry department to further his education to become a PA. We had a full-time assistant to leave us with just a 2 weeks notice. And that's hard in the busiest season of the year, which is in October, one of the busiest. So I had a conversation with Matt and asked him would he step into this position. Now remember, he has graduated from undergrad just 2.5 months post. He could have said, no, I'm not ready, or no, that's too much with the academic load I'm carrying. But he didn't. He stepped right in. He accepted. He worked very long hours, very long days, and not ever once complained. He never asked for a day off, and he always would always ask, was there anything else that could be done? The entire year this year, I've watched Matt work countless hours, feeling about as bad as a person could possibly feel. But yet he continued to amaze us all with his work ethic. Matt, your character is one of humbleness and perseverance. Your work ethic definitely represents your Christian character and dedication to Emmanuel College. Everything that you have endured this year just boasts your humility, your tenacity, and your determination. You have been a testimony to not only me, myself, but to the entire athletic staff and student athletes. It is an honor to serve alongside you and be a part of presenting you this award. Would you please come forward?
Bill White Award, your awesome athletic director, Nate Mormon. The Bill White Student Athlete Award is given each year to a male or female student athlete who has contributed to the athletics program by their outstanding performance, outstanding team leadership, and individual achievements in academic excellence. Named in honor of Coach Bill White, who established and coached the first intercollegiate basketball team at Emmanuel, this award signifies the highest honor a student athlete can receive at Emmanuel College. To present the award with me, I'd like to ask the award winner's coaches to come forward and share with us about this year's winner. To start, we'll begin with the female winner of the Bill White Award, and I'd like to ask Coach Bonna to please come to the stage.
Would Michaela Cromley please come to the stage? In our locker room, we have posted up what our team's 12 core values are for the year. On the top of that list is the first core value that really sets up the basis for all the other core values. And it's based on scripture in Matthew 6:8, where Jesus used these words to summarize the Sermon on the Mount. His words were simply, "Don't be like them." I'm sharing this because the student athlete who has been selected for this most prestigious award has lived out those words, "Don't be like them," since she has arrived here 4 years ago. To call her special would be somewhat of an understatement, for today that word seems to be very overused. So to describe her, I'd like to use the word exceptional. First, she has been exceptional in the classroom since she has arrived here from Pigeon Forge High School, where she was their school's valedictorian. She currently has an amazing 3.98 average in a very tough physical therapy major here on campus. She has already been accepted to the PhD program for physical therapy at the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga. Very exceptional. Second, she has been an exceptional athlete, being selected as a two-time All-American this year and was selected by the coaches as Player of the Year in the South Region of the NCCAA and First Team All-American. She has helped our team to four consecutive trips to the national tournament, making it to the Final Four of the last 3 years. She has also reached the coveted 1,000th point club this year, and we actually have the actual game ball that she scored her 1,000th point with that we'll give her here in a minute. Third, she has been an exceptional teammate. By her example, she always gives all she has all the time. I have called her the machine for how hard she works. And she just keeps going and going and going. Something like the Energizer Bunny, I guess. Fourth, she is always encouraging and lifting up her teammates. In 4 years, I have never heard her say a negative word or comment to any of her teammates or coaches. It's been said a good teammate is one who is hard to play against but fun to play with. She certainly has exemplified that on our team. And finally, she has been an exceptional leader on our team. She is rather soft-spoken, but she's kind, she's patient, and she's been a living example of a lady off the floor but a strong-willed competitor on the court. On our team, she has set the example of how a student athlete is supposed to conduct themselves, and she has set the bar really high. She has shown what it means to be exceptional. She has truly separated herself from most and has followed the Lord's statement of don't be like them. Us coaches and teammates feel exceptionally blessed to have had the opportunity to have her as a part of our team and see her receive this prestigious Bill White Student Athlete Award. Congratulations, Michaela.
Bill White Award winner and share some of their experiences. I'd like to ask Coach Alan Gilchrist.
When I was a kid in the 1980s, I grew up in New Jersey, and we had this really neat invention. It was called a walkie-talkie, and I could call my sister from the backyard, and it would go something like this, you know, Gail, this is Alan, over. And I just thought that was the most amazing invention. And you'll appreciate this story really if you're in your 40s or over. But in 2014, I used my smartphone for the first time to call someone from around the world and talk to them almost face-to-face. And I thought back to that story of the 1980s that I just shared. And I kind of look at my cell phone as like an amazing walkie-talkie that you can talk all over the world. And I share that story with you because I want you to understand how integral a part of the coach's life each one of you are. You can hear coaches tearing up when they talk about their student athletes. You can hear administrators and trainers and professors and coaches get choked up because you student athletes become such an integral part of our daily lives, and you become woven in a fabric and a part of our lives that's a part of our story. And I hope you can hear that in my voice, how important each one of you are. In my recruiting process, my team knows we don't spend a lot of time talking about individuals. We talk about the team. So when I recruit, we had 27 internationals from 12 different countries or 5 different continents on the team. So athletes from all over the country and all over the world that God sends here to Emmanuel to learn, train, and grow. And my team knows that we don't talk about them as individuals. We talk about the team concept. So when I recruit them, we don't talk about what their accolades from high school and things like that. We talk about what can they do here for Christ at Emmanuel? How can they grow as a young adult here at Emmanuel? And we take that seriously. But I want you to know that you are woven into our lives. And so as I have this student athlete come up, this is the student that I talked to for the first time in 2014 on my phone, all the way from Europe. And I could see him and he could see me, and we had that awkward conversation for the first time. And, you know, I introduced myself and told him about Emmanuel College and what God's doing here. And it has been, this student athlete's been a 4-time academic All-American, 10-time conference champion. He's been my senior captain. But what's so much more important to me is he gets what God is doing here at Emmanuel, and he takes it seriously. And he has been so respectful to everyone that he comes in contact with here at Emmanuel College, representing the school, not only here on campus, but out in the world. And it's always our goal to just be that part of helping you to learn and grow and train you up so that God can use you once you leave here at Emmanuel. And so it has just been, I can't say enough about this young man, your coaches, they love you. We love our student athletes. And we're so proud of you. And if you haven't heard that, hear that now. And we care about you. And I just wanted to share that with you. I appreciate you listening. But now we're going to focus on this one young man. He's our senior captain. And it has been our privilege to be his teammates this year, and it's been my honor to be his coach for the last 4 seasons. And that is Adrian Alexander.
Misses us. I'd like to ask for a few people to stand and be recognized. You can give them a round of applause. First, Mia, Juan, and Alexis, thank you for doing a great job tonight. Savannah and Dr. Rackley, as well, for volunteering their time. Take pictures. And last and certainly not least, if we can have everybody recognize 4 people that really helped a lot to put this together. And 3 of them are probably not where you can see them, but they are standing right now. And that's Guy, Lance, Catan, and Inga. So this year was another great year for Emmanuel Athletics. let's continue. Let's remember our spring sports are still competing. Let's continue to support them as they prepare for their postseasons. But in the end, just like to thank all of our coaches, all of our support staff, but more importantly, all of our student athletes for having another record-setting year in Manual Athletics, for continuing to work hard. Let's continue to work hard and have another record year next year. So thanks for everybody for coming out, and I'll turn it over now to Pastor Chris.
Okay, we would like for all of you senior student athletes to stand. To pray for you, and if you are not one of the student athletes who are standing, we're going to take a moment of silence, but I want all of you to be praying for them. You can kind of keep your eyes open and just look around at them, but don't get distracted, don't be doing anything else but praying for them, and then close your eyes and I'll lead us in a corporate prayer. Heavenly Father, just look around at these students, these student athletes. God, those who are standing, God, I thank you that you have gifted them. They've understood the importance of hard work and dedication. But God, I thank you that you have stood up for them. You have taken a stand declaring that you love them. And that you have a plan for each of their lives. And our prayer tonight is that, God, they will live a successful life. Not on the stat sheets or the news reports or the world popularity list. I pray, God, that they can live a successful life in the kingdom, in what matters most. God, that they can find success in understanding your love and displaying that love to other people. God, as I stand here, I think about those who are standing, but all of us. And I just imagine, where will we be in the future? God, what will these student athletes be doing a few years from now? 2 years, 4 years, 10 years, 2 decades from now? What will they be doing? God, my prayer tonight is that they will be following you. That you will be standing up for them, and they will be beside you, letting you guide them, and they will not live with regret, but they will be glad that they put you first, and they decided to be on the winning team as your daughters and your sons. Bless them, and we pray for the future of Emmanuel College and the athletic department and all of the areas of this institution. Let all that we do be pleasing in your sight, O God. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Thank you. Let's clap again.